Hello students, I'm back again with a new video. I welcome you all in the e-learning class of mathematics. Today in this video, I shall explain you about the properties of addition. So let's understand chapter 3 addition. Our topic is properties of addition. Students, addition is having few properties. So let's understand one by one. Okay, our first property is order property of addition. Now what is this order property of addition? I've taken an example. You can see 2 plus 3, our 2 plus 3 is 5. Okay, in second case 3 plus 2, 3 plus 2 is also equals to 5. So what you can see here, student, in the first case 2 was at the beginning and 3 was in the second position. Okay, in the second case 3 was in the beginning and 2 in the second position. That means simply I have changed the order of the number, but the answer is same in both the case. Okay, suppose 4 plus 6 equals to 10. Now let me change the order of this number. These are called addends. The numbers that are added are called addends. Now let me change the order of these addends. Now let me write 6 first and then 4. Our answer will be 10 only. That means the order property of addition says that if we change the order of the addends, still the answer is same in case of addition. Okay. Next property is grouping property of addition. Students, if we have more than two numbers, for example, I have taken three numbers here. So how will you add? So we can add these numbers by grouping method. Okay. We have to add in a two step. First, we have to add any two number and then we have to add those two number answer to the third number. So there are two process: begin at the top, begin at the bottom. Like we have 2 plus 5 plus 1. So what we can do? Let us add the two numbers from the top. Okay, 2 plus 5 is 7. Now we have 7 and here 1. So it will be 7 plus 1, it will be 8. Okay, now begin at the bottom. Another method, you can start from the bottom. So 5 plus 1 is 6. Now 6 plus 2 is, we can have 6 plus 2, 8. Okay, so in grouping property, we have to group two numbers first and then we have to add to third number. That grouping can be either by taking the first two digit, or grouping can be done by taking the last two digit. Okay, but the answer in both the case it will be same. Now third property is zero property of addition. Means if we add zero to any number, the answer will be the number itself. Like 2 plus 0 will be 2 only. 0 plus 3, the answer will be 3 only. That means when 0 added to any number, the answer is the number itself. I think these properties are clear to you, student. Now let us see exercise 3F. Fill in the missing numbers by using the properties of addition. Now we have learned the properties of addition. By using this property, we have to fill in the blanks. Our first question is 7 plus 4 equals to 4 plus, yes, 4 plus 7. Which property is this, student? This is order property. Okay. Now 509 plus 1234. Here dash has been given plus 509. So which number is missing? Our 1234. Simply we have changed the order. Like 509 plus 1234. We have changed the order. 1234 plus 509. This is also order property of addition. Okay. Now 0 plus 1854. We have already learned the 0 property of addition. If 0 is added to any number, the answer is the number itself. That is, answer will be 1854 only. Okay. Next question is 2 plus 5 plus 3. Okay. We have 3 numbers this side. Okay, now let us see on the other side, it is 2 plus 5. Our one number is missing. So, which property is this, student? In this first case, we have grouped first two digits and then added to third. Here again we can see one digit is missing. So which is that digit? That is 3. Okay. This is grouping property of addition. Next, 35 plus 28 plus 104. Again 3 digit is here, and again here we have 2 digit. 1 digit is missing. So here we have grouped first 2 digit. So here we have to group last 2 digit. So our 1 digit is missing, that is 104. Okay. Our next question, find the sum by adding down, then add up. I've already explained in the grouping property. We have to first add from the top and then we have to add from the down. You can see here 6, 9 and 3. 3 digits are given. So let us add from the top first. 6 plus 9, it's 15. Now 15 plus 3, it is 18. In the second case, we will start from the down. So 9 plus 3 is 12. Now 12 plus 6 is 18. In both the cases, the answer is same. Okay. I think this much is clear to you. And our chapter 3 is completed, student. Thank you so much.